Das Marinas, which is named to be as the university town of Cavite, truly pushing its way to become an industrial giant of Calabarzon, as it was declared as a city through a plebiscite conducted last November 25, 2009. The city also proven that it really follows its motto, Sulong na, sulong pa, lungsod ng Das Marinas. As one of the fastest growing local government unit of Cavite, let us all together discover the facts, government, and the people behind the success of Das Marinas Cavite. The city of Das Marinas was a first-class city in the province of Cavite. Prior to its conversion into city, did you know that it was the only municipality in the Philippines that had both SM and Robinsons Mall? Here is a quick preview of the city profile gathered from the website of Cavite Provincial Capital. Additional information has been given also by the city mayor.
Das Marinas is located at the center of Cavite with a population of almost 800,000 as of last census, as of 2010. Meron kami iba-iba ano, kami residential, industrial, commercial, may agriculture pa rin. Also known as University Town of Cavite, since we have 19 cities and universities in our city.
Let's have a quick historical background of Das Marinas City. The name Das Marinas came from Gomez Perez Das Marinas, a Spanish governor of the Philippines during the Spanish era. Before, it started as a barrio of Imus and it was made into an independent municipality in 1867. Mayor Barzaga had mentioned Das Marinas City as the university town of Cavite. And in terms of number of barangays, it is the city which has the second largest number of barangays, having a total of 75 barangays. Now let's look closer on Das Marinas City seal. Actually, it was the new city logo which has unveiled last November 26, 2010, created by a skyscraper city forumer and a graphic designer named Ryan Suarez. From this seal, it was described that the rising sun represents happiness, life, and spirituality. These figures represent the strong ties of Las Marineños united in realizing their goals. The wreath stands for Das Marinas as a university town of Cavite, wherein one can find first-class colleges and universities. The buildings stand for progress involving local, commercial, and industrial institutions, which means a sound economic standing and better opportunities for the residents. The church signifies the different beliefs and faith, which makes it even more conducive to the city's progress. The gear stands for industrialization, continuous growth and development. It also shows the city as it evolved into a highly urbanized, industrialized, and first-class city. And lastly, the globe shows that Das Marinas is globally competitive and is working on being recognized not only in the country but worldwide. Now, let us discover the officials behind the city of Das Marinas.
Hello everyone, we are here at the Das Marinas Cavite to conduct an interview in the municipality of Das Marinas.
And now, let's discover the officials of this success. Let's go!
During the research, it was known that the Das Marinas City Mayor is Honorable Jennifer E. Barzaga and its City Vice Mayor is Honorable Valeriano S. Encabo. And in terms of number of its Sangguniang Panglungsod, it has a total of 15 members. Executive and legislative power has been stated by the city mayor.
Of course, I'm head executive, that is the mayor. I have also department heads and unit heads in the city. And also the legislative power composed of Sangguniang Panglungsod. And the SP or Sangguniang Panglungsod members is headed by our Vice Mayor Valeriano.
It was clearly stated that the head of executive power is the mayor, while the legislative power is the vice mayor and the Sangguniang Panglungsod. Specific powers, duties, and responsibilities of the city mayor has been gathered as the team visited the office of the Department of Interior and Local Government, headed by its operations officer, Mrs. Nencita N. Costello. According to her, the following duties and responsibilities of the mayor are the following. Duties and responsibilities the city vice mayor has also been given. Being a mayor or a vice mayor of a certain municipality is not an easy task. From this view, people who would like to run for this position should not just have full dedication to serve the state, but also attain the following qualifications. According to the Local Government Code of 1991, it is stated that an elective local official must be a citizen of the Philippines, a resident therein for at least 1 year immediately preceding the day of the election, and be able to read and write Filipino. Candidates for mayor or vice mayor of highly urbanized cities must be at least 23 years of age on election day, and of independent cities, component cities, and municipalities must be at least 21 years of age of election. About the mayor and the vice mayor's term of office, it shall be 3 years from the date provided for by law for at least 3 consecutive years. Now that we're done with the city mayor and the vice mayor, let's look closer to the Sangguniang Panglungsod members and the barangay officials. It has been mentioned already that there are 15 Sangguniang Panglungsod members in the city. Now, here's a quick preview of the barangay captains in each of the barangays of Dasmariñas City. Specific duties and responsibilities of the Sangguniang Panglungsod members had also been gathered in the DILG Dasmariñas. According to them, their tasks are the following. Duties and responsibilities of the barangay officials has also been given. Being a member of a Sangguniang Panglungsod or a barangay official also has qualifications to be followed. To aspire one of these positions, here are the following considerations. He must be a citizen of the Philippines, a registered voter, and in the case of Sangguniang Panglungsod, he must be a registered voter in the district where he intends to be elected, a resident therein for at least 1 year immediately preceding the day of election, and be able to read and write Filipino. Candidates for the position of member of the Sangguniang Panglungsod of highly urbanized cities must be at least 23 years of age on the election day, while 18 years of age on the election day for the position of punong barangay or a member of Sangguniang Barangay. And just like the others, the terms in office of the Sangguniang Panglungsod and the barangay officials shall be for 3 years for not more than 3 consecutive terms. And finally, let us know the local government structure in the Philippines. As you can see, the president is on top since he's the head of the state. Each division at each level from the provinces down to the barangay is a local government unit or LGU. We are under the province of Cavite, in which you will notice may have municipalities and component cities. Dasmariñas City is the second largest component city in the country. The city has been governed by the city mayor, next is the vice mayor, then its legislature is the Sangguniang Panglungsod. Dasmariñas City is composed of 75 barangays, which is governed by the barangay captain, and its legislature is the Sangguniang Barangay, composed of barangay councilors and SK chairperson, and with a separate assembly for the youth sector, the Sangguniang Kabataan. Now that Dasmariñas City is fully established, let us know the opinion of some residents about the conversion of the municipality of Dasmariñas into city.
Sabi kasi city na, di ba?
Apo.
Medyo na sinabi kasi pag nagiging city na, kung anong pindos.
Apo.
Dasmariñas?
As a city po.
Wala, improving.
Babar po ba sa pagiging city ng Dasmariñas? Or mas gusto niyo po na normal ang city?
Doon mo malalaman kung umuundad ang isang lugar pag nagiging city na siya. Ibig sabihin, nag-i-improve siya.
We've been done discovering the facts, government, and the people behind the success of Dasmariñas City. Thank you for watching the city's documentary. This is Veloce Madobas reporting.